Welcome back to my channel, friends. This is Sonia here from Growing Craft, and I'm super excited and super happy to share this video. So yes, very recently I was connected by Loveline from Let's Get Crafting, and I was super amazed to see her collection, to see her products, and I was so excited to try my hands on that. And they were so generous enough to send me some of the amazing and beautiful MDS stuff. So yes, I'm a mixed media artist, I'm a decoupage artist, I'm a scrapbooker, but I love MDF stuff. So this was a good and a very huge haul for me, because I love their MDF products and I really wanted to try my hands on them. And yes, of course, what also tempted me a lot was their stencil designs, which I absolutely loved, because I love using patterns and textures on my bases. So yes, this was a huge exciting time for me to try my hands on their supplies. So yes, this is a big pouch or the packet, you can see what I have received. Now let me share with you what all I have got here. Okay, so yeah, actually I cannot do the unboxing completely on the screen. Why? Because it is a huge stuff, and of course I want to show you everything in detail. Now, the very first thing which actually caught my eyes was this antique frame. So they have this very nice packaging. So yeah, this is an MDF base. Now I am so sorry, because you can see this is open. Why? Because I had opened this. I was super excited the moment I got this. So yeah, this is the base, and this is what it contains in this pack. It's an 8x12 size frame with this cutout and a base frame, and just imagine the kind of variations you can do with this. So yes, they have even posted one pic of the sample piece. Now let me open this for you. So this is how the packaging looks. It comes in a plastic packaging, and of course you have seen the cardboard packing, and this is the base. Yes, so the size is actually really good. Like I mentioned, the size is 8 inches by 12 inches, which is a little bigger than the usual nameplate size what we make. So of course, if you have a bigger surface, the variations what you can do is a lot more. The kind of detailing you can add is a little lot more, of course. So that gives a big thumbs up to this product. Now let's move on to another one. Now the next thing which extremely tempted me was this vintage pot frame. Now honestly, when I saw this one, I really liked the design what they had created, and I will tell you why I picked up this one. Let me just show you this one first. Okay, so I just need to open the tape. I haven't opened this one because I wanted to be a little good girl, that I do not open everything in advance. Okay, so this is a huge pack. I'm so sorry for this plastic noise. Okay, now let me just keep this aside and show you this. Now this comes with a packaging of so many little teeny mini pieces. Now here, as the backing says, it has 3, 4, 5 sets. These are actually two pieces, this is three pieces. So the base size is 12 inches by 12 inches, which is extremely big size for an wall panel, the MDF wall panel. And the size of the pot, which is going to be here, this is 4x3. So this is actually a very good size for any of your keepsakes and having something really decorative and nice, beautiful here. Okay, so yeah, this is how it is going to be. So let me just show you how this is. So this is the one panel which is of 12 inches by 12 inches. Then we have these three rectangular panels, and then we have these cute cuttings. This is going to be assembled as a pot here, as shown in the picture. So yeah, this is going to be really exciting. And yes, we are coming up with the live sessions with their products, so you need to stay tuned on our Facebook page too, so that you do not miss out this tutorial. Now, next. Okay, of course, when we are saying decoupage and mixed media and say it any kind of crafting, decoupage papers have taken such a huge space in our craft room because they are so versatile. So yeah, these are the few of the designs. So these are the mosaic tile designs which I have picked up. I have also picked a few of the element design papers. Now, one thing which I generously wanted to share with you all is the thickness of these papers. So I'll just open one piece right now. Okay, now whenever we say decoupage papers, they have to be really thin, because otherwise it is as good as having any pattern paper, and then it just fails with like meeting up your requirements. So this is literally so thin. Like if I take up any of the normal print paper, and with that, even this papers are really thin, and you can just see the design. They have left a very minimal space on the side borders so that you can use this whole sheet, or you can even use these on the patches, and they are going to look absolutely beautiful. So this was one of the reason why I really wanted to try my hands on their decoupage papers, and they look absolutely beautiful. Okay, so now let me just show you and give you a walkthrough of some more designs. So this is a beautiful pink vibe, and this looks cute. So I'm just thinking maybe we can cut out these elements and use it on our base and do really nice mixed media textures around it, and this is going to look fab. Then this is the cutest one, the romance and blooms. This has a cute cycle with a teeny mini. Can you see the envelopes here? This one, they look so gorgeous. Then some of my favorite mosaic designs. So you can use these as it is on any of your, maybe in a decoupage tissue boxes, and then you can have this on your complete surface, or you can cut out these small pieces, each blocks, and use this as your tile effect for any of your vintage projects. They are going to look absolutely gorgeous. So while even I'm talking to you, I am so excited to just imagine that what kind of variations I can do with these supplies, and this looks gorgeous. So yes, these are few of the decoupage papers, the really thin decoupage papers, which is going to serve your perfect purpose of decoupage. Now, the next most exciting thing was to have these wooden elements. Now, this is a pack of a bigger size wooden elements. Usually when we say wooden elements, embellishments, these are wooden embellishments. So when I'm doing my mixed media, I actually say wooden elements, but yeah. So this actually has, let me just take it out. As you can see, I have been very sincere. I did not open this pack earlier. Okay, so it comes with the three frames. This is the base frame, and these are the two pieces. So what you can do is you can have this and do nice shaker element. You can make this as a multicolored frame. You can make these as a 3D frame, and they're going to look fab. So now this one is in baby theme. In the similar way, they have something in a love theme also. Can you see the how many beautiful detailings they have given here? This looks gorgeous. Then with this, what I really loved is some more wooden elements. Then this is another one, a beautiful ring with the floral pattern. Then what I have is a Ganesha. This one was gorgeous. This one is to die for and beautiful. You can use this on your nameplates, your mixed media projects, your scrapbooks, your card making, and they look absolutely fab. This is a beautiful pattern. I am already thinking that where I'm going to use this, and I have tons of projects in my mind right now. This one is another one of my favorites from their collection, because having such designs is not available every time, and getting these custom made is very difficult, but they have all the designs which, being a crafter, we need on a regular basis. Now here, the fun part was they have this in two sizes. So if I'm using this bigger one in a nameplate, I can use this as an element for a similar frame or a wall art next to it, and it is going to complement it so well. Same thing happens with the Ganesha also. Then what I loved was these beautiful elements. So these are the MDF elements, as you can see here. I hope you can see this. So these are just perfect for your mixed media. Like even if I'm doing a decoupage art, I just want to highlight one part of my element or my base. I'm just going to pick up this one. I'm going to stick it and work on it, and it's going to look fab. These are a few more beautiful wooden elements, and they were so generous enough to send me some of the supplies for free. And of course, they have been so generous. Now, after wooden elements, what I have is the stencil. So like I was saying, I was dying to try out the stencils. Why? Because they have some of the beautiful elements. Like when I had shown you the first frame, so this was the first frame which I had shown you. So it has a nice vintage stencil. And when I saw their catalog, they had two designs in this one. I think they have some more designs too. You can check their page. I'm going to post their link down in the comment in the description box. So these are the two ones, and just imagine how versatile they are. You can use them on your welcome boards, your nameplates, and your wall hanging, and they are going to look beautiful. Now this is a bigger size stencil. Let me just tell you the size of the stencil. So this one is approximately, I'm just measuring the text. This is almost 9.5 inches by 2.5 inches, which is a very good size, and this just fits perfectly for any of your nameplate bases. That's the best thing. Then of course, this cute little mandala was one of my have to picks from their collection. Then I really love this quote. Always believe that something wonderful is about to happen, and it happens if you really believe in that. Okay, then this was another one of my favorite pattern. I had seen them using this in one of their projects. I think it's in this. Yes, so actually when I saw this project, I had decided that I am going to have this stencil, because it looks, this is so pretty, so beautiful. And here I have the same stencil. Then this is one of my favorites. So honestly, I've been using stencils from so many brands, but of course the designs and the detailings and the quality matters a lot. So of course, I know there are many stencil brands and Indian brands, international brands. I'm just in awe with the kind of design and detailing they have come up with, and they are so versatile. Now with the festival seasons coming up, you can just play around with them in different ways, like maybe with coloring your furniture or your tissue boxes, your nameplates, your wall decor, your trays. They are so versatile, and they are going to blend in with your Indian and your Western projects so very well. So yeah, these are so many. I can't even say few, because they are so many beautiful and amazing supplies from Let's Get Crafting. And yes, of course, I am sharing down all the supplies link down in the description box. Do check that, and of course do visit their store, and I'm sure you are going to love this. Of course, do not miss out on any of our live sessions, because we are going to come up with a live session using their products and creating a beautiful artwork for all of you out there. And just in case if you have missed out on subscribing to our channel, please do that. Thank you so much for watching, guys. And yes, do not forget to participate in our live sessions. And thank you so much for watching. Take care. Bye-bye.